Here's a close-up of Ethan's face while the game loads. He looks so sensitive. He looks like a hurt little puppy. Oh God. I'm actually eating while playing this, so I'm hoping nothing is going to happen that's going to cause me to lose my appetite. I'm chowing down on some Wendy's chicken nuggets and french fries. Nothing gourmet. This is the old power plant on Something Street. I didn't actually finish reading the notes that told you what it was, and I didn't review the footage of yesterday's play session, even though I could have theoretically if I wanted more clues before jumping back in, but I feel like I already have maybe a little more insight into what's going on than the player is supposed to have, just because of paying attention to what's happening at a very high level. So I kind of don't want to spoil the game for myself too much. So I can either go back up, go back down, or, oh no, I guess the down prompt is just to climb down the other side. Careful there, Ethan. Don't crank your skull before you even get inside the building. Careful. The door looks rusty. You don't want to get tetanus. It's locked, but I don't see, like, any other options for getting in. Those windows look heavily frosted. I'm not sure if you can actually see anything through them.
The main entrance is blocked up. There must be another entrance somewhere.
Yeah, he wants me to actually, like, circle around the building and look for another way in. There's a butterfly here, and I unfolded an origami butterfly in order to receive instructions to go to this location, so that painted butterfly is like a message from the killer, or from the killer's accomplice, or from whoever staged this scene, telling me, yes, you are at the right place, and I'm watching you, so you better play along. At least that's how I interpret it. Danger, electrocution. Please keep clear. I can't quite read that sign. But yeah, there's barbed wire. There were no prompts there, but there's a prompt here. Oh, there's a hole in the fence, and there's barbed wire covering up the hole, so Ethan has to... Jeez, Ethan. Just grab the wire once and don't grab onto the barbs. Kind of grab in between, please. Alright, I have to hold up. Now R1. Good. Oh, that was easy. R1. R2. Alright. Oh, fuck! I didn't miss any of the, I didn't, like, let go of the buttons or anything. Ethan just decided to, cut his hand on the wire. I hope the mystery girl is still, hanging around the motel waiting to help him if he gets too badly injured on this quest, because, this is looking dangerous. It's raining heavily, and, there's, like, gigantic, you know, sparks of electricity. Not even sparks, like bolts of electricity just like jumping between those conductors, like right up here in the open air. So like realistically, if you stood this close to these conductors in the rain, you'd have a very serious chance of getting electrified just from the electricity jumping like through the humid air, like right to your skin. And he's also walking on the ground, which appears to be moist earth and grass, which makes you especially, you know, susceptible to electrification. And before I go in, here's one more butterfly. So I know I'm in the right place.
This is the old big old power station. I thought it was abandoned.
the old Pico power station, if it's abandoned, then the generator should be turned off. There should not be electricity all over the place. I don't know why he's opening this. This was just the first prompt I saw. Hang on, let's back up a little bit and look at the rest of the room. I don't like the look of that vent. I don't get what just happened. I guess he tried to pry that door open with his hands and it was locked from the other side. This is the vent that I really don't want to mess around with. And this is the way I came in. If this was me in real life, I would continue circling the building and look for other ways in, but I have a feeling this is what the game wants me to do, so I'm gonna do it. They put a book of matches at the entrance to the vent as though to say, yes, it's going to be very dark in here. And this is all I'm gonna give you, so be careful. Oh, okay, if I shake the controller, I'm actually putting out the match. Hang on just 1 second before I go in here. I'm just gonna heat up my food. This is really seriously terrifying. I'm not even going to pretend that I'm okay with the implications of this setup. The first one was like terrifying too, where he had to drive the wrong way on the freeway, but it happened so suddenly that there was no like time to be scared because the request was so abrupt that like it just made me feel like, okay, let's do it, fucking let's kick some ass. But this is kind of like, you know, he leans in, I let go of the button, he leans in, I let go of the button, I just really don't want to go in there. Oh my god. I'm just going to stay out here for like maybe 60 more seconds while I grab some medicine because my nose is super stuffy, and then we are going to go in there together, you and I. I hope there aren't rats. I'm terrified of rats. Okay, I have procrastinated as long as I possibly can. That just makes him look. It changes the camera angle a little bit if I hold up for a while. Here we go. Circle. L1. That's it. Just two buttons, not too bad. That doesn't make sense. There's nobody in that room. If someone was so close behind him that they could have entered the room and, you know, closed the door behind Ethan, then, like, I feel like Ethan definitely would have noticed that. because I'm sure his senses are on high alert. He's really nervous about this. Oh my god. It's broken glass. We're gonna have to crawl through broken glass.
Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it slowly so I don't tear up my arms.
Yeah, like really slowly. What I would do if I were you is actually like remove my shirt maybe and bunch up my shirt. So it's just wrapped around my arms, and my arms were like, you know, quadruple layer padded. But Ethan isn't smart enough to do that, so he's just going to have to take the pain. Ow! 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 Do you see that red stuff appearing? Alright, he's striking a match.
Indicates where the fresh air comes from.
It indicates where the fresh air comes from. The match flame is blowing to the right, so I think the fresh air is coming from the left. Does that make sense?
My vision's getting blurry. Easy does it. I've got to move slowly.
I think I'm supposed to go the opposite of the direction of the match flame. Because, if the wind is blowing... If the wind is blowing in... Yeah, okay. There was a false alarm. I saw a prompt, so I followed it, but I think...
I'm gonna die in here if I don't find a way out soon.
Alright, that's a dead end. So that's like a clue. That, I guess he automatically turned around. But that's a clue that, I'm doing it the opposite, and I need to follow the match flame instead of going opposite the match flame.
Indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind.
Alright. The camera angle is changing all on its own just to mess me up and try to make me lose my sense of direction. But that tunnel to the right is where I came in. And now I'm taking a path which is one right turn away from where I came in. And now I have to stop here and strike a match. What happened? What happened to you, Ethan? Ethan? Did I not go slowly enough?
I couldn't. I wasn't able to.
I don't get what I did wrong there. I think, maybe I went too quickly, but I only ran into one dead end. I made one wrong turn because I thought, I wanted to go to where the wind was blowing from instead of where the wind was blowing to. But, someone opened the entrance for me, so I guess I could crawl back out the way I came. I definitely didn't manually steer Ethan back the way he came. And I earned a trophy called Coward. So Ethan was not able to pass the second trial, and, I don't know if his quest to save his son can go on now. You saw how short that was. Maybe my problem was that I was moving too quickly over the glass. I was supposed to be moving slower, more slowly, but I was just like barely pressing the stick up. Alright, now we're, the mystery woman again. I'm gonna call her Madison because that's what she says her name is, but I'm suspicious of her.
Calm down, girl. There must be something I can do to help him.
I wish you would think aloud and tell me who she is and why she's here. The controls are a little wonky. I guess I can't walk anywhere until I help him.
Oh my god. What happened to him? He's unconscious. He's bleeding. Shit, what could have happened to him?
It sucks. I really wanted to pass that second trial. I wonder if that's based on a timer and, Alright, L1. R1. Pull him up. And now, up. I just have to do it slowly, I guess. I wonder if the second trial is based on a timer, and all the time I spent just standing still waiting to go in was actually being counted against me, and that's why Ethan pooped out so quickly.
Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me?
I told myself before I started I wasn't going to go back and redo anything, and so far I regret shooting the suspect as Jaden, and I regret not passing this trial, but what can you do?
I'm gonna have to get your clothes off.
I'm sure you've taken a man's clothes off before, Madison.
You're gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds.
He's conscious. He's in good shape for an architect. He's been staying fit through his 2 years of moping and being depressed and not shaving.
Your arms look really bad.
No shit.
I need to disinfect the wounds.
Alright, let's just get up and get the disinfectant. We know where that is. It's on the top shelf. He left the origami figure box out. I'm actually gonna have Madison take a look at that. Maybe she'll learn something.
Origami figures? What is he doing with them?
She thinks that is suspicious out of all the things she's seen so far. That's really rich. It's not suspicious that he keeps, like, going out and coming back wounded. It's only suspicious that he has origami figures.
I'm no doctor, but I'll do what I can.
Disinfectant first.
Your wounds are disinfected.
Now, bandages, right? Because you have to bandage the wounds after disinfecting them. Wait. I needed ointment first. Can I go back? No, I already chose bandages. I guess he's not getting any ointment. The medicine is probably the painkiller. He's gonna be needing that.
He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. I hope he wakes up.
I screwed that up. I'm not even getting the option to use the ointment now, or the painkillers. There's a proper sequence for that, I assume. I guess you can tell I've never gone to nursing school.
Thank you. How do you feel?
He feels,
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the guardian angel act? You don't even know me.
Memory? What does she remember?
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block.
Well, she's from the rough and tumble part of town.
I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
The wrong side of the tracks.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac.
Tell him the truth. I want to know the truth myself.
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to get. I do what I can to live with it, but,
That was a very vague truth.
It's not easy.
I want to know more of the truth than the explanations.
That's the second time I found you in a bad way. You always seem to be running for your life. What's happening, Ethan? You mixed up with the mafia? Owe someone money? Something like that?
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Help.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot.
He's not very helpful. He's not very happy with me because I didn't do a very good job of bandaging his wounds.
I'm gonna go. Take care.
I can tell from the outcome of some of these scenes that there's like so much more to this game than what I'm seeing, and if I chose different options, then this would all be playing out like very differently. I want to see some of the alternate outcomes, but I also just want to see how the game ends, and I want to follow this story through to its conclusion because it's my story, right? It's the concept of the game. Everyone who plays it gets their own story, and you just have to live with the consequences of your decisions, and life goes on. I'm just going to spend a moment out here in the rain, see if anything happens down in the courtyard. Maybe we'll see some lovers walking hand in hand, picking up autumn leaves and sprinkling them in the air above their heads. Maybe we'll see anyone who has a normal life without, shredded knees and overactive tear ducts and a bad liver. Maybe someone will decide to sell me a leather jacket real cheap. The jacket I've been wearing is kind of, it's past its prime. There's some really shoddy window air conditioning units on the building next door. I don't know whether that's another motel or like a cheap apartment complex. I hear the sound of a motorcycle. Someone's revving it up. It looks like there's a patio chair. Can I sit in it? I can.
Must stay on my feet.
Sean.
I'm coming, Sean. I'll find you wherever you are.
Madison.
I don't want that girl to get involved. No one must know until I find my son. No more failures. I've got to get those goddamn letters.
I don't want him to think rest because I don't want him to rest. Oh, There's the fridge. I bet there's some water in there. No? No water? That's what I was looking for before when he said he was thirsty. Maybe because I didn't drink water. He was too exhausted to go out on that second trial. Okay, here we go. It's an origami lizard. Are you prepared to make a sacrifice to save your son? 9711 Marble Street.